photography and imagery has always been important in the music world. You know, it's the way that you put your image out there for people to understand what it is you're about, you know. And I think in the 80s there was lots of outlets for imagery. You know, we had all the different rock magazines and music magazines, and people liked them, you know. People bought them and read them, and they were kind of like what the internet does today. You know, they passed along information about the bands, and they came out like once a month or twice a month sometimes on some of the on some of the magazines. So you were like, you know, pretty caught up with what was going on. You know, if you were a fan, you know, you were capturing the antics, you know, the imagery of the time, and the which was really unique, you know, when you look back on it now and you go, wow, that it had a look and it had a feel and a sense of I don't know, there was a romanticism about it. There was some sexiness going on with a lot of the photos, you know. It was a cool time. And I tell people nowadays who are young, you know, what they ask me, well, what was it like, you know, growing up in the 80s and being in the rock business and all that? And they can't believe the stories, you know. They really? That happened? You know, people did that? Yeah, people did that. And it's a whole different world. It was a lot less conservative than it is now, you know. Definitely a wilder time.
Retreat.